Please be seated.
Your Excellency, sir.
For me, today is a special day because whether you like it or not, you must make me an Odupani son today. Before I even start, let me ask that in a way I have seen the modernization of our dance today, I think I am in for another study. So I am going to offer a token sum of 500,000 to the dance groups. Because I want to learn that their style. What I'm used to is a Shoki dance. But what I saw today, it was a charismatic combination of Shoki and another complicated version. My great people, today is the day for farmers. Great farmers! Great farmers! Great farmers! Farmers! Today is our day. I am a son of a farmer. So I am. As a son of a farmer, and as a farmer, I do recognize the challenges farming and an African economy. I do understand also the difficulties in sustaining agriculture as a permanent lifestyle. Therefore, you've got a governor who understands your challenges, have lived in it, grew in it, matured in it, civilized in it. Therefore, have a delicate combination of the pains and pleasure that comes with farming. Therefore, you have a right governor who will work with you and see you through this process. The CPN Borrowers Anchor Program is a critical program that was introduced by federal government, and we must seize this opportunity to thank President Buhari for introducing this program. We must thank him because at this point where the vision is being born, if you lack the capacity to see beyond your heart, you will think that this program is going to be very difficult. But if you follow the roadmap, if you follow the plan and vision, you will definitely know that this is the beginning of the emancipation of Nigerians from their continuous dependence on foreign imported rice. Therefore, I ask all of us to participate and also to celebrate and thank Mr. President for the introduction of this program. I want us all to thank Mr. Godwin Emefiele, the CBN governor, that I have continuously put under pressure, telephone calls at a very unholy hour, insisting and asking that Cross River State not be part of this program. That's why I thank the CBN governor who actually had to go through all of that story to explain that what we are here to see today is a product of consistent pressure. And that's why I took my time to be in Kebbi when the president went there to flag off this CBN Anchor Borrowers program. The Rice Value Chain Initiative that we are standing here today to perform is a special ceremony that will increase rice production in Africa because Nigeria is the epicenter of Africa. The choice of Odupani as the first place to flag it off is the significance of Odupani in the entire agro landscape of Nigeria. Odupani is so blessed. We have all the seasons. We have extreme, excessive landmass. When I brought a team from Mexico, when we were searching for soil to grow banana for commercial export, they located Odupani as their choice. So the biggest banana plantation in Africa is also coming to Odupani. The finest sons and daughters that we have in this government are from Odupani. My Commissioner of Finance is from Odupani, and you have seen one of your daughters performing excellently here in Odupani. Why wouldn't I be an Odupani son? Sure I am. I want us to thank this government because the vision of trying to be self-sufficient in rice production is critical. But as Cross River said, we will add our own dimension to it. While we understand the CBN Anchor Borrowers program, we also understand that off-taking capacity is key. When we start producing rice to a point of gloss, There must be a mechanism, a financial model that must offtake this product. That's why Cross River State today is using this opportunity to officially announce that the government of Cross River State is ready to set up a proper professional food bank, the very first food bank in Nigeria. We are going to set up a food bank, one in each local government area. The major essence of the food bank is to serve as a catalytic financial muscle that will pick up, buy off, take off every single piece of rice that you will produce. That way, you are guaranteed a steady income. We are going to have an agricultural exchange center, which will also be headed by a very key professional that will, in synergism with the food bank, buy off your rice, give you predetermined value, add value to your product, and ensure that for every single farmer who returns to go and grow rice, he'll be proud and happy he did. The farming we are going to do in Cross River is also going to be special. Cross Riverians are known for class. We are known for elegance. We are known for beauty. We are known for style. Therefore, I cannot return you to the modern atavistic farming methods. So what Cross River State Government is planning to do is to actually provide an agricultural mechanization center to provide industrialized support for farming. That is why I spent 3 weeks in Thailand and in Taiwan, living in the farms. And that's why I dressed the way I did, just to underscore the fact that the governor too owns the farm. The governor has lived 3 weeks in a farm settlement center in Taiwan and in Thailand, understudying the rice farming method. Farming is pleasure. Farming is like honeymoon. Farming is good. Farming is excellent. There's nothing much more exciting than putting a seed in the soil and seeing it grow to maturity. It's like nurturing a child. The spiritual vitality of such an offspring growing into a full adult that would then, in biological sense, begin to provide energy for mankind is so excellent. Therefore, from the Negro spiritual perspective, it's also a good thing to do. But not to talk of the way we want to farm. We are going to have agri-cities and agri-towns. As you take your rice and go back home, we are going to ensure that all the support you need, particularly from the point of equipment, factory support, machineries, and all the tractorization that you also require, will be supported from the state government. Because state government must support CBN and indeed federal government to ensure that you don't farm the way our fathers did. I don't want a farmer who farms in tears, but he must farm with pleasure. And that's why I want to assure you that as Cross River State is setting up a food bank, so you are going to have a food bank in Odupani, whose business is to buy all the rice from you. So as you have started, as you start your planting, there's already a food bank coming to knock you that I'm paying you for your rice that you are going to harvest in 3 months' time. So you have a guaranteed income. And what are we doing with the food bank? You must realize that the elegance of a society and government is measured by its capacity to take care of those who are very challenged. And therefore, the vulnerability of your challenged society and the way you take care of them is a measurement of the social barometer of the performance efficiency of the government. If that nexus, plexus, and connectivity is correct, then you will agree with me that the measurement of the sources of the government of Cross River State will be how much the food bank will be supporting our people, our brothers and sisters that are too old to farm, too old to work, be physically challenged, the loved ones who don't have people who care for them. Because truly, if a society is sensitive to the needs of the downtrodden, then you have a spiritual society. Then God will come into that society. That's why the food bank will cater to those who can fish no more. That's why the food bank will provide food for that old widow who is back home without a child, but is dying because his stomach needs to eat. Food bank will take custody of all of those. These are programs I did even when I was a senator. For those who come from Northern Cross River State, you know I have established food bank across the 5 local governments of my senatorial district. If I could do it as a senator, I would do much more as a governor. And how did it start? When I saw the hunger and pain in the faces of my people. When you go on campaign, sometimes you run into an aged woman. She's about 80, 85 years. You come back and see she's got no child. She lives in a thatched house. The rain falls through. She can't find a meal. So what's the essence of government if you cannot cater to such people? That was why I set up a food bank. And I did an inventory of the poorest of the poor in every village. I said, give me a list of all the poor people. Every month, we deliver food to them. And that's what the food bank could do. And now, what are we doing? We're increasing the demand curve for your rice. Nigeria spends $400 billion annually importing rice, an additional $60 billion in December. So basically, as the exchange rate was then, Nigerian government was spending $460 billion importing rice. That's what President Buhari wants to stop. That's the essence of this program. And so beyond the value chain that I have mentioned at the level of the state, it has a nationalistic and continental outlook to put an end to the declining rate of the dollar, the naira to the dollar. And so by the time we stop the import of rice, we're also adding value to our naira. It is key that you appreciate this point. CBN Governor, Mr. Godwin Emefiele, and in particular, President Buhari, have a concept that I think we must support. I pray that Cross River State should show a different example. Because when you take these rice and grow it properly, and we buy off from you as state, and when they see the total yield, then they will know Cross River State is the right place to go. And so by next year, our vote will come higher and bigger. And so we'll capture more people into this race. Don't forget also, with the establishment of the garment factory, CBN again have said, look, we are ready to bring all Cross Riverians who are ready to go into cotton farming, to provide them money to go into cotton farming. Because when we grow our cotton, we can then produce fabrics from them and take them to Calabar, to the garment factory, and produce the uniforms. Today, the army uniform, customs, immigration, civil defense, prisons, NYSC, the list is endless. The garment factory of Cross River State will be the main factor that will generate